Hey guys, what's up? It's Alec Torelli, and in this video, I'm going to show you how to use a poker variance calculator for both cash games and tournaments. So you could do important things like plan your bankroll, figure out your variance, your ups and downs, what your hourly rate is, your ROI, and much, much more. Stay tuned. This is a poker variance calculator, and it allows you to do just that, calculate your variance in poker. This is a website called Prime Dope. It's free to use, and I'll walk you through how to do it. This is extremely important if you're looking to make poker a viable business plan, a viable business or a side hustle, or you want to turn pro, because you need to build a solid foundation. This is the equivalent of having your house built, and the strategy is putting the artwork up on the wall. That's always what I tell my clients. Do not skip this step if you're trying to figure out poker as a business plan, your viability, what variance you can experience, your hourly rate, etc. So I'll walk you how to do this through both cash games and tournaments. So the first part of this video will be for cash games. And if you'd like more from this, you can check out our membership in Conscious Poker, where I walk you through much more detail of how to use this program to better manage your bankroll. Let's dive in. So the first step here is to measure your win rate in BB per 100. What is BB per 100? BB per 100 is big blinds per 100 hands that you are going to win. So if you're playing 2-5, one BB is $5, and how many of those you win per 100 hands is your win rate. That's how poker players measure win rate. So you play about 25 hands an hour, so BB per 100 would be how much money you win in 4 hours, okay? Because you win 25, you play 25 hands per hour, so your BB per 100 is how much you win in 4 hours. Now, what is your win rate? Well, hopefully you keep poker records, and if you don't, you should, so you could actually input your statistically significant data in here. But if you don't keep records, you're gonna have to estimate. So if you're a winning player, your win rate will be somewhere between 1 BB per 100 and 40 BB per 100, okay? So use that scale to speculate on exactly how good you are. And it's hard for me, it's possible for me to know where you fall on that scale because I don't know how good of a player you are. And so you're gonna have to guess if you don't have records, and you'd be humble and figure out where you are in respect to the other winning players at the table and then guess your win rate based on that. So I would say, let's say for example, your win rate is, 20 BB per 100, that's 5 BB per hour. So if you play 2-5, that's $25 an hour. Don't worry about this. Standard deviation, I don't want to bore you with, but I don't want to get too much into the weeds here. So let's just leave this as 100 for now. This is the variance you can expect to experience. And number of hands to simulate. Well, this depends on how often you play. So if you play, 25 hands an hour, remember that. If you play 20 hours a week, that's 500 hands a week, 2000 hands a month. You could enter that number here and simulate your variance for the month. Now scroll down here and you will see, all of these different metrics. Okay. Don't worry about the other stuff here. But look at this chart here. Expected winnings, 400. So you multiply this by 5, that's 2,000. 95% confidence interval, important to keep in mind as well. 95% of your results will fall within this range. So you'll either lose this amount, which is, again, multiplied by 5, so about 2,500, or you'll win this amount, which is about 6,000. So this is the range that you can expect to experience within a month. Probability of loss, any given month is 18%, so 2 months out of the year you will lose, so you should expect that. You can see here how you're starting to be able to project things. You can project things like, well, how much money do I need? Well, if I'm gonna lose on average at the most, $2,500 a month, well, my bankroll better be able to withstand that, right? So these are important things to keep in mind because you can make inferences on what your bankroll needs to be or how often you should be losing on expectation. And if you're losing more than that or you're losing more than this amount of money in a month, you know that you are not winning at this rate or you know that you need more money within your bankroll. You can start to make these sorts of plans. Scroll down. This is another important section. Downswing extents. This is the number of big blinds of downswings you will experience. So 1,000 plus big blind downswing, which means, you know, $5,000 at 2.5, will happen about 4% of the time. So I always tell my clients, you should definitely plan to have a bankroll big enough so that your chance of your bankroll can withstand you having a downswing extent where the probability is less than 1%. So you would want a 1500 big blind bankroll. And this basically ensures that you have a less than 1% chance of going broke, which is important, right? If you're planning a business on how to do this, you want to gamble responsibly, invest responsibly. You want to make sure that your chance of risk of ruin is less than 1%. So your bankroll would need to be 1500 big blinds or more. Actually, more than that, because you can lose 1500 big blinds, which means your bankroll needs to be, you know, 2000 or 2500 big blinds to plan for what to do after you lose 1500 big blinds. You can win that money back. Downswing stretches. This is how many hands you can lose, right? How many hands you can be on a downswing. Well, you can see here you can be on a downswing for about 10,000 hands or more, 4% of the time, which means you're going to lose potentially for a couple months. That's definitely possible. So it's important to keep that in mind as well when planning financially how to play poker. Let's take a look at tournaments here and how this works. Tournaments are a lot different than cash games because there is a lot more variance. And I will walk you through some of that now. So let's say the average tournament you play has 300 players. It pays 12% of the field. That's about standard. The buy-in, let's say it's the same as the 2.5 player. Buy-in's 500 in 2.5 no limit hold'em cash games. Let's say it's 500 in tournaments. The fee, $30. ROI, now again, this is difficult to measure, but it's probably between, if you're a winning player, you know, 1% and 50%. So if you're equivalent to the cash game player, let's say it's 20% ROI. Again, if you have records, you can measure this. Even if you do have records though, your records might not be accurate simply because it takes so long to reach the long run that even if your records for the past 2 years say that you're winning or losing at this rate, they might not be statistically significant. It's probably largely due to variance. So inputting those numbers here will be too arbitrary to make inferences. So you're going to have to do your best guess. Or if you play online tournaments, you can have a bigger sample size that is more statistically significant, and you could extrapolate those numbers to give you a better sample. But you're going to need to have at least 1,000 tournaments to get something that's, I'd say, statistically significant. So, you know, if you play a tournament a week, that's 20 years. So it's hard to have reliable data. But this program is so powerful because it allows you to make inferences based on what your probable win rate is, based on how good you are at cash games or how good you are as a player overall. And you can estimate what range your win rate is in. And then you can make inferences about your bankroll that you need. That's why I like to do this exercise personally with clients, do this one-on-one with them, because they can send me all their hands and I can see exactly how good of a player they are, compare that to the rest of the field and understand exactly what their win rate is likely to be, not exactly, but very close to what their win rate is likely to be for both cash games and tournaments. How many tournaments are you going to play? Let's say you play a tournament a week. That's 50 tournaments a year. And let's simulate this 10,000 times. That means we're going to get 10,000 samples. Okay. Scroll down. Don't worry about this. 20 random samples. It's just that. 20 random samples. Not significant at all. Statistical data is what you want. So your EV here is 5,300 for the year. Okay. So this is for the year. Compare that to cash games. It's a lot lower. Probability of loss is 50%. So even if you are a winning tournament player, one of the better winning tournament players, if you play 50 tournaments a year at this ROI, you still will lose 50% of the time. That is insane, right? This is why I highly recommend that people have a balance between cash games and tournaments for what they do for their bankroll, and that tournaments are a small part of their bankroll, like you would think about, you know, high-risk investments in your stock portfolio, and cash games are the majority of their bankroll. If they want to make a profit long-term and make poker a viable business, because they're so much more stable. 99.7% confidence interval. This is means that 9,970 out of 10,000 samples will fall within this range. So it basically means that every result will be within this range. So you're either going to lose 25,000, and remember, your buy-ins are 26,500. So you're basically either going to lose all of your money or you're going to win about 100,000. That's the range that you can expect to experience. So you can see here the range for tournaments is so much higher than the range for cash games. We only did cash games for a month, but even if you were to do it for a year, the discrepancy between what you could win and lose in tournaments is way higher than it is in cash games because there is so much more variance. There's so much more luck. So a lot of people like tournaments because they can have disproportionate reward to their risk. They could risk 500 and win 50,000. Whereas in a cash game, if you risk 500, the most you're going to win is what? 2,000, 3,000. So it's more stable, but there's less variance. So that's why I think having a mix of both, depending on your personal needs, I like to work with clients to figure out exactly what that balance is for them that makes sense based on their goals, the money they have, where they're at in their poker career, what their personal life is like, and their overall bankroll to come up with a plan that makes sense for them. I talk about this more in my membership as well at Conscious Poker, which you can get access to at the link below, where I walk you through an entire course on how to build your bankroll, how to plan for your poker future, how to set your goals, and make sure that your bankroll is working in synergy with what your long-term aim is, and that it's giving you the best chance of success with minimizing the risk of going broke. So you have the best chance of a high ROI, but minimizing your chance of going broke, and how to construct a bankroll so that cash games and tournaments are working in synergy and finding out what's right for you. You can get more access to that at the link below, and there is a free trial available for that. I hope you loved this video. Please subscribe to my channel if you like it. There's more awesome content coming your way. Thank you so much for watching. I appreciate your time and attention. Much love, everybody, and I'll see you in the next one. Cheers.